five basic shapes. Is, what is it? That's a cube, right? It's a cube, and there's a, well, here, what's the technical name for this?
Tetrahedron.
Huh?
Tetrahedron. Tetrahedron.
Pyramid. I can't even pronounce it. And a sphere, and a cone, and a cylinder. Okay. Now, anything beyond these shapes are a variation or a combination thereof. All right, now, so here's the situation. The darkest star should be perfectly next to the lightest star. Now you work from dark to light. See that? There. Dark here, and then it gets lighter as it goes back into the atmosphere. Stronger here. And then there's a cast shadow. And a cast shadow is keep it free. Don't make it hard, because then it becomes a negative shape and it looks like a hole in a canvas. All right, now on this side, if the light comes from over there, I forgot to do that, see? So then you work from dark to light, see, here. See, dark to light, there, see? All right, now over here, I'll use my finger here. I mean, it still goes what I said about the other, but, yes. There, see? Now, a little darker there. This whole thing is a little dark. Okay, now, darker there. You work from dark to light. From dark to light. From dark to light. So right up on here, I don't think this will show anything. Yeah, maybe it shows a little. So your biggest contrast would be right there. And next week, when we do the composition, that same thing will hold true in a composition. Okay, now here, see, there's your darkest star. Now, if it's a small, how do you spell that? See, from dark to light, and work across the four, not down, but across it. See, now here it is, from dark to light. Okay, now if this were a skyscraper or something, then as you get near the top, then it fades away. But right down here is your lightest light. Okay, cast shadow. There. Okay, sphere. Right there is your darkest star. Right about there. Then you have a reflected light. See, again, see, you work from dark to light. Now this is quite difficult, all right? Then you have a soft turn coming around here, and then softish in there, and then right in there, you know, you usually see that window that they could wear a glass wall or something, see? But that's your lightest light is over there. All right, now, there's your shadow. Now this. Your darkest spot is right through here. The light is coming from over there. Now you work across. Top. And there. I don't know if you can see over there. I mean, you just have to look at it later, because I can't stop, you know. Like I said last week, we must reach Boonesboro before nightfall. Okay, see that? So right through here is the lightest slide. Okay, then you cast shadow. Okay, now here, well, since I drew it like that, we have to reverse the light. There's your darkest star. See that? And then it gets a little lighter. Then again, you work from dark to light. It's lighter over here because, see, this goes back into the atmosphere. All right. Now then here, don't go like this, because then it looks like a shiny stovepipe or a pipe. So right there is the darkest star, right through here. And then you have, then you go around like this, and then there's a soft turn right there. And then you have a 10% turn up here. And then, so in this case, your cast shadow would be over here. Okay, now, I just want to put a little respect to that. You can shade this, you can shade any, or any variation or combination thereof, you can shade anything. Okay, now, when I used to teach here, near the end of the season, people would say, Mr. Abraham, can you suggest this summer where I won't have a model, what should I draw? So I say, draw a still life. And they say, oh, but that's so boring, you know. I said, well, draw still, I can learn more from that than anything. So what I'm going to do now here, this in a sense is a still life, and it'll be a variation or combination of all of those. Only this is a step further toward the figure. Then we're going to draw the figure over here. And later on, we have another board over there, we'll do a figure from life, or half figure. Probably a portrait, I'm not sure yet. Okay, let's go. Well, that's a bottle, right? Let's draw another bottle. Okay, now we'll put an apple. Let's, you know, we'll draw. You want a cylinder or square?
Square.
Huh?
Square.
Square? Okay, square. Have it over that beside here. Okay, we'll make this an apple. There. Okay, now we'll put a cylinder down here. Okay, now. Now, if you set up a still life at home, now this, there has to be a table here, right? See? So let's just use some drape. If you arrange the drape interestingly, this is at home now, you know. So don't scoff at a still life. Okay, well, let's. Now watch this step on the right. Okay. Now we have the top, right? The light is coming from over there. So inside it's dark over there. Now right through here, right through there is a darker star. Okay, now I have to use a finger here. Nothing wrong with using a finger, just so you don't think that. The secret lies in that smooth stuff, you know. That's for the birds, that smooth stuff. All right, now let's do a thing like this. There. All right, now there's a soft turn right in there. All right, now right here we have this, see? So this is going to do this again, make it a little lighter in there. Then this then casts a shadow. Onto this one, see? All right, now here it comes like this, something like that. Now we'll make this a square box. Let's go like that. See, there, okay. Now, the light is coming from over there, then this will be very dark. See, and then even if from there, it might even cast a shadow onto there, see? on one side? Okay, now. Let's make it a red apple. Just generally here. Okay, now. There. Let's create a dark over there. Okay, now, see how there are your combinations that are these shapes. All right, now then here, then this has a cast shadow from there, cast shadow from there, and then as this goes into there, it gets a little darker. All right, and now it's getting to be like this, only it's a variation of that, you see? Okay, now over here then, all right, now this, let's say, cast the shadow up to here, maybe over this partially. Okay, then here's this. All right, instead of just a cylinder, let's make this a thickness. Let's make it a heavy vase or something like that. There, see? Okay, now, are you with me so far? I'll try not to use Jesus' time, but I'll try not to use too much time. Okay, let's go. Now here. Great. Okay. Let's have this drapery go across here. So and then this would create a shadow over there. And then there you see this type of a form over here. Okay, now in front here. See, your darkest star is next to your lightest light. What's going on?
It's in the lawn.
Car.
Yeah, car.
Okay. Now you see the light here? Now this, there would be a highlight there. Now right here, see? The lightest light is right there, see? And then it gets a little bit darker here as it goes away from there, see? By apple. So there. Lights over there are now through here then. What is that, in the school or outside?
Outside. You want the windows?
What's wrong with this neighborhood? See, there's the same thing. Okay, now I'll do this quickly. Jesus Christ. Cash from that. The same thing over there, but we're going to set that up, but we don't have that much time. Now, if this is pretty close to the wall, then this thing would cast the shadow onto the background, see? But it would end somewhat, but softly. Alright. Now, here's your light. Like we said over there. I mean, is this coming through at all?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, all right, quickly here. Let's put a reflective light on there. I just use any color here without even giving it a thought. Well, I mean, this could be worked out more, but we haven't got time. We have to keep going. By the way, in case you're interested, for those of you who like perspective, when you draw this kind of a thing, like here, see, then how do you draw this shape? I'll show you how. Here's your axis, and you make a perfect perpendicular through here, and then you draw this like that. See it? There. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Enough of that. So, well, I know that we'll be back around. So, you know, then then it's a matter of detail. We haven't got time for that. She's on time. Look at that, it's already 7:30. We got a half hour after the rest of it. Let's carry on. There you are. We're going to do the last half hour, we're going to draw him. What is he? Hi. We're going to draw him. Okay, next. Block. See that? somewhere in here is where it changes. You'll soon see as I keep going here. Okay, now, right in there, that's the upper arm. That's where the vein is, and that's where the plane changes. Okay, now, deltoid. See, now we bring this form around here, and then now your latissimus is in there somewhere. Okay, then there's the clavicular portion of the pectoralis major. If I call these muscles wrong, keep me straight, will you, Douglas? Keep me straight, okay? Because, you know, you could make a mistake. No, nobody's perfect, you know. Alright. Now, this stuff all applies here now. Now right in there, there's a past shadow. Okay, we'll do it like this. And unfortunately my eraser is in my pocket. I can't reach it. But that's alright. Now there's a muscle here called the what is it, brachialis?
Yeah.
Brachialis.
Got it straight? Brachialis, okay. Brachialis, which comes around here, and then there's your triceps, which comes in there like this, and these other muscles. Well, we haven't got time to name them all. This is the tensor communis digitorum. I call it the Bruce Lee muscle, that's this one here. But we're not going into the muscles too much here now. Okay, then there's a chest, there's an areola. Now this becomes a plane in there. Okay, now since we're doing this, since a light is coming from up there, then this would cast a shadow, just like this stuff over here, see, onto this form. Okay. Alright. Now there's your clavicle. There's your sternocleidomastoid. And the other one comes around here like this, and there's your sternocleid, right? Is that it?
Sternohyoid.
Huh?
Hyoid?
What, you mean this?
Yeah, no,
this. What's this called?
Adam's apple.
Huh?
Adam's apple. Adam's apple.
Oh, yeah. You know why? You know, women don't have Adam's apples. You know why? Because Eve gave hers to Adam. Oh, wow. Alright, now, I'll do this as fast as I can. Alright, now, comes the masseter. And the underneath here, and the mouth, and the nose, and the cheekbone, and all that. Well, we're not going to go into this too much, because we're going to use them later. Okay, now, here's the other clavicle. Now, from here, the center, then there's the chest. Okay. Now I'll show you why, as I'm doing this, I think of frequent mistakes that I made. Alright, there's your ribcage. Move like this. Okay. Side, front. Okay, now. This comes out, this comes out, and then the thickness of the ribcage goes in, and then the rectus abdominal muscles, they come through here, something like this. Not really the way you would shade them, but the planes, because this is a plane lecture. Yes, it's a plane like shape. Okay, so here's this muscle and here's the other one, and here's this one and here's this one, and then this comes out this way, and your navel is on the part that comes out, then this goes in again, then it comes out again, like this, comes around like this, and then, well, this is obvious, right? And since we're drawing a man today, this comes out, this goes this way, right? So, now look at the change plane, the planes, changing planes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. See that? Well, unless you think like that, unless you think abstractly, you never learn to draw. Just to copy the model of battery doesn't mean a damn thing. Huh? Mm-hmm. Or it will polish it, you know. You know, the damn thing, huh? Okay. Now, somewhere through in here, see, right through in here somewhere, is where a plane changes. Gotta be careful with this, I don't want anything to start. That's it. Okay, this is front. Okay, now, then there's the latus and the scorsium here, and the external oblique, which is opposite the navel. So now, there's a plane turn there. My rib cage is up like this. Okay, now, this goes in. Let's go like this. This whole thing is done as a tone. There, including part of this, and part of this, like that. And this, and this. Okay, now you're beginning to see it better. All right, now we work into detail. Okay, now we have this, and then this comes out, and then it goes in, then it comes out, in, out, in, out, in, out, in, and so forth. Okay, now, then you have your stomach, your two rectus abdominal muscles there, and then you have the lower stomach here, and then this extra thing which goes like this and then this. Okay. Now this comes around here, and now over here then the same thing. I'll put this somewhat short. And then there's your navel is in there. Okay, now through here. See? Now we're getting somewhere. See? Now let's say the stomach muscles, the rectus abdominal. See? There's maybe a bit of a cast shadow from this one to this one, because over here, see, here you have a plane coming, this comes out. I'll do this with a red chalk in a minute so you see it. Okay, now there's a cast shadow in there, of course, and this muscle inserts this clavicular portion of the pectoralis major goes all the way up to the clavicle. Now we have to show the plane turns of the clavicle. Now you see this thing here now? That, like any variation thereof. Okay. Now this then casts a shadow onto this. See? And there's it. And this is over here, and then this thing casts a shadow into that gap, and onto here, and then this casts a shadow onto this, so all this would be dark, and then this thing here would come like this. Remember, a variation of all this. Yeah. Does it make sense back there? I hope. Now, sometimes, you know, these muscles would be over here, and then these muscles over the chest, they pull across. I'll just do one of them. See, it goes in there like this. They pull across. There are usually two or three there. They pull across like this. Okay, now the chest. See, then it gets a little darker in there. And this would still be dark, right? Because it's an underdark, or partially dark. Now there's a light in there, like over there. And then this will cast a shadow partially on the other chest. Okay, now I want to show you a frequent mistake that students make. Now you got to articulate. See, if you don't articulate, you have nothing. Boy, that shit is annoying.
It's a car alarm.
Yeah.
A car alarm.
A car alarm? You mean somebody's car?
Not the car.
Okay, now. See, now unless you can feel the ribcage coming through here like this, then you have failed. All the polishing in the world isn't going to save it. See? Okay, now then I've seen people do this. So they have the ribcage coming around here. Then they draw the chest like this or something, you know. The chest has to be outside of the ribcage. It's got to be out there. You've got to make room. It builds around the ribcage. Okay, you know. Now there's your external oblique over here. There. Okay. Well, just right there. This is what I want to show you. Stop. Oh my God. Reminds me of the guy that was laughing when somebody beat him on the head with a hammer, and then he was laughing and laughing and laughing, and so his friend said, "What are you laughing for?" He says, Just think how good it'll feel when he stops. Okay. Are you with me so far?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, now, see, now right there, this comes up. So this would have a tone like that. Yet, all this is darker than this side. All right, let me just do this quickly here. This. This. Now we have a slight tone over there. Now, the mistake a lot of students make in a fully shaded drawing, they only shade one side. They don't shade here. This needs a 10% turn, otherwise it isn't round. Okay, now, one more thing over here. See, right in there, it gets darker because this goes in and this muscle comes out. So in order for this to come out, it's got to be lighter than this. Is that too involved for you? Are you still with me?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now here. The ear, masseter, dark, and here. Well, we're going to do this later, so we'll stop there. Okay, now. Where's that orange? Oh, I guess that's an orange. See? All right, now, over here, there's your triceps, which comes through here like this. And this goes in there, and this comes through here. This muscle inserts between the triceps and the
brachialis.
Okay, now. So this is basically like this. You see a plane turn there? Or this is basically like this. See? But that's not enough. Or this is like, oh, by the way, this should be. You know, unfortunately, my eraser is in my pocket, so I can't get at it right now. Okay. There's a block over there. So this basically goes like this, and like that, and like that, and like that. There, this way, and that way. See that? You see your blocks? All right. Now this is not just like this. It comes like this. Like this, like that, and then like that. See that? While basically it's a plane like that. Okay, now here, over here. Let's see, what should we use for the, let's use a blue for this. light, no. Yellow? Light. Those are your lights. Okay, now your dogs. Do you see what happens there? Now, if you see that, then you're in business. Okay, now over here it would be like this. This comes around here like this, goes like that, then it comes out like this, and then across there and then there. This comes out like this and across there, back in there, and then back in there like this. I didn't do a cast shadow back in there, so it's down on the base. So it's so bad. Radical. Oh, up here. This is dark. This comes around, and there's a kind of a void in there. We used to call that the ashtray. You dump your ashes in here. Okay, here it is. So now this, see, this is basically a thing like that. And this, of course, is like this, and like that, and then like that. All right, now, this business here, the clavicle. So it stops there, this comes down to here, and then there's the other one, the one underneath. And there's another muscle in there, this comes around here like that. I mean, this, like, you just don't see that and go home and say, ah, now I know the secret. No, you have to work at this for the rest of the year, right? You know, you've got to stick your neck out. Okay, now this has to come out more. All right, then you find the areola. Well, with a woman would be better for this, but it's okay. Yeah. And of course here, well, we're not going to do this now. I'm going to draw a leg if we have time. Okay. Is this making sense at all?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
All right, now I will quickly. Jesus Christ, that's okay. I'm going to look at my notes here so we can get something done. Get back. Okay, with me. What is it?
Trapezius.
Center line. Oh, before I forget, when people turn, you know, they know that the center line is in the middle, see? You know, but when you turn it, like here, see, the center line is, here's your center. But when you turn it, like here, then your center line is between this and this. That's what I meant before when I said ABC. Okay, now over here we have the same problem. Is this, there's the back, there's the other, what is this called? Lumbar region. And the sacrum and the golden diamond, as they call it. And then external oblique and all that. Yeah, so I'll try to do this quickly because I still want to draw a leg in here. Somebody requested a leg, so I have to draw a leg. Okay, now, here's the same problem. See, this is your... This goes in like this, up to there. Then it comes out this way. And then this comes out this way, and then this... If we round this off, and then there's your great trochanter, buttocks, gluteus maximus, to you technical term. Sometimes it's easier to say buttocks, but it's faster anyway. Okay, now, we'll stop the arm there because we need that space. Okay, now the shoulder blades. See, if the arm goes out that way, the shoulder blade goes along with it. Scapula to you, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, now, I really know the terms, I just don't know if you're paying attention. Okay, now, so this one will go this way, if the arm goes out that way. So we'll make that arm go out that way. Okay, now, let me stop with you. Now, here's a mistake that students make. They draw the neck like this. See that? What they don't, what they forget about is this. See that? Mm. They forget this. So this goes up in the back. This is the back of the neck. But then there's the side of the neck. That's your sternum and mastoid. That's this thing here. Okay, then if the head goes this way, then if it's forward, you know, then there's a flame turn here, and like this. Okay, now, then through here, right in there is your seventh cervical. Seventh cervical vertebrae. Okay, now, then, not that stuff. Okay. The thickness of the clavicle. Now, over here, see, now all that stuff on the left comes to the fore here. See, there's the clavicle. What am I saying?
Scapula.
Scapula. Okay, you see what I mean? Well, you know, after a while, you know. Okay, now. So, now there's your... come on, quick. What is it?
Terrace...
Terrace major. Terrace minor. I have rhomboides and infraspinatus deltoid, which comes through here. Okay. Triceps and so forth. We're not going to show this because we don't have time. Hurry up. And then here, this is a good place to show you the planes. So here we are. What is this?
Great Japan.
Great Japan. Tessa Pashilata. And these, this, whatever, semitendinosus and so forth. Okay, now. I'll do this quickly. Now through here then, here comes that principle to the fore again, see? If then it gets lighter, start there, a soft turn, 10% turn, a turn over here. This whole thing would be darkish here, a cast shadow on there. You'll soon see what I'm doing. Now we come to the light in there. See that? Now we're getting planes. Those are planes. And that's what's hard to do. That's what people forget about. Okay, now a cast shadow. Same principle as over in that still life. There's a cast shadow here. But then there's a dark here, like here. Soften just a little bit. And then it just comes back in there. And then it's working across the form, like this. And then there's your sacrum, see, dark in there. It's lighter up in there. And there's your external oblique through here, about like that. Again, you think of blocks, this wraps around like that, this comes out there. There's your tensor fasciata, and there's your... So right for cancer. Alright, now over here then, now here, sometimes you see the spine. It depends on how a person will feel. If they're lean, then you see the spine through here. Then you see some of the vertebrae through here. So here they are. And then there's a cast shadow coming down onto here. And then there's a dark plane turn. Then you have the same thing as here. So, and it comes around, and over here in the spinal cord, just all this stuff, there's this one. And this throws a shadow onto that, see? And then there's your lattice and the sparsi, and your rib cage comes in there. And now you're, this. Come on.
Teres major, lattice minor.
Do I have to concentrate all the time? You can muscle in, come on. Okay, now articulation. See, if you don't know your anatomy or your articulation, see this? See that goes like this on the man, this is a jump, this goes back and this sticks out, this comes out like that, and then like that. See how important that is? Okay. Now this distance comes around like this, and there's a thickness in that. Sometimes this is very dark in there. Okay, now here. Too much time here. Okay. Here's this, and here's your. Okay. Now here's your neck. See, here's a plane down here. This is your center line, see? And then there's your twisting wrist that's out like that. See that? It's a variation of those first five shapes there. Right now, then right there, this comes in a little half shadow, and then there's a little dark over there. And then this, as it goes back, is slightly darker because your lattice light's in there, but only now it's a little different from last week, because last week we had a female. This time we're doing a man. Alright, here's this, whatever it's called. Okay, now, let's quickly do this now. See, so this comes like this, see? This goes like this, like that, across like this. Or over here, there's the great trochanter up, across, down. See that? Here it goes across, down. And as this comes down here, then it goes up and across like that, see? You got to think like that, and here too, so. In the spine up here. So here, see, you think like this, see, like that, yeah, like this, like that, and like that, see? Or here, across this way, up, and across this way. And here, up like that, and across this way. Okay, now quick. The leg request. I'm going to try to do that in 5 minutes faster. I'm going to do it tiny bit fast. Iliopsoas, pectineus, abductor longus, Gracilis and semitendinosus. You see, so you have actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 muscles all across there. But you forget that. You learn it, but then you forget it. Then you shelve it. This is what you, this is how you got to think then. Now you do this. See that? Shave blocks again. Like our shapes over there. And this is over here, and then there's your shin bone.
Tibia.
Okay. Now right there is a thickness. See that? What, there's a thickness there, see, which goes like this. And there's a thickness here. And then right in there is the bone, and then this whole thing is another plane. See that? And then there's your kind of saddle back in here, just like it is over there. All right, now. So let's do this with the light we're coming from over there. Vastus medialis, which is the muscle here. And the older a person gets, the lower that muscle is, it seems to drop. I don't know why, but it does drop. Now, all right, now over here then, see, now you, there's a thickness there, see? All right, there's a thickness there, and there's a thickness here, it goes like this, see that? And now the sartorius, all this thing becomes a side flame, and then as this connects down here, then this casts a shadow there, and then this comes down, see, there's that other one, whatever it's called. It doesn't matter. Names are not important enough for this kind of thing anyway. And now right through there is a flame. See that? Now over here then we have our soft percent turn. See that? You work from back to life, back to life. Now there's a thickness in that. And then you see sometimes these are very well developed, so they show, otherwise they don't even show. Now this inserts, well, this. Yeah, this inserts in there. Sartorius comes through here, like that. And this inserts in there. There. This one, there you are. So now, what this amounts to is this. It goes like this, but it does not go like that. It goes like this, like that, and then like this, and then down here. And this goes across like that, this goes this way, this way, this way, this way, and this thing here goes up, down here like this, and across there like that, down here, out there like this, down here like that. You see the directions? Mm-hmm. This is going there more. Break. Right there. see this way. Now turn your head that way. Too much. What am I crazy? I'm living such a peaceful life. Can you get a little more attention to your body? You know, don't just sit there like you're comfortable. Now, when you were sitting back there, you were a little more, you know, intense. So look intense. I mean, don't look as though you're troubled instead of having a good time. Okay? Look the way I feel. That's better. That's it. Okay, fine. That's it. The trouble is just too far away from it. So I have to do this course. Just take the same thing. Bring the chair forward. More. Or. There. Bring that one so he doesn't have to strain his legs anymore. Okay. Now. That's better. See, he lost this again. You're, that's better. I'm just going to have to do the side view of this. Like that. Push this in. This whole thing.
He wants to push that over. He wants to push that over. Can I help?
No. See, I'm standing over there and I'm the one that's coming over here to my work. You don't need to come out of here.
If you were brave.
More. 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 That's it. More. A little more. That's all right. Don't worry about that. That's it. That's it. Now, can you hold it?
Yes.
I will say one thing though. Maybe I heard an eye. If you get the eye in the middle, right smack in the middle, you can't go wrong. You get a good composition. Hold your mouth still, don't mess around with it.
Thank you.
I Well, some people can't get the feet on the page. Look what I do. Yeah, but it's because I didn't want to bend. Well, it's not a painting, it's a drawing. It's 1 minute to nine. Can I stop? Can I stop?